Hey there, Iain Toombs from Go Fishing. Today is a little bit out of the ordinary for me, really. Normally, coarse angler, fishing rivers, canals, lakes, commercials, that sort of thing. But the first time ever, I'm on the beach now at Aldborough in Suffolk. It's just phenomenal, really. I've always wanted to try this sort of thing, but never done it before, really. I'm here with Alan Yates, Paul Fenwick from Sea Angler, Mel Russ from Sea Angler magazine, and Lloyd Rogers, the power photographer, deals with all the fishing titles. And been invited along because they're doing a test today on budget beach casters, fixed spool reels, big pit sort of fixed spool reels. And I've got one on the go now, first cast. Don't really know what I'm doing, to tell you the truth. But the rod's in the air, and it's a bit, well, it's not dissimilar to fishing the Trent. But there goes the tip again. But as opposed to the Trent, I've got a little bit more confidence here, because the lads down there have already caught a few whiting, about that sort of size. Cod as well, codling, which are about sort of £2, just over £2. It's, yeah, great fun. So, evidently, I've got a two-hook flapper rig on, size 1-0 hook, a 5-ounce gripper lead, and on both hooks I've got a full ragworm tipped with a little strip of squid. So I'm going to give it a try, see if I can catch my first sea fish. It should be a good laugh, this. I'm hoping for a codling. But evidently, you'll catch them here to, according to the experts over there, you'll catch them here to about sort of 4, 5, maybe 6 pounds, maybe a real big one if you're lucky. So we're going to see what happens. Well, I've given it 15 minutes to say fish to the clock here, something I'm not used to at all. Normally used to catapulting a bit of feed out, trying to bring the fish into the swim, that sort of thing. But here it's basically, as you'd expect, a massive expanse of water. I've got two baits on the hook, relying on the smell from the two baits, relying on putting it in the right place, which is, I reckon, about 50, maybe 60 yards out. Alan and Paul were fishing a long, long way out this morning. They was picking up small whiting, about that sort of size, but they're coming a bit closer, and now they started to latch into the codling, which are a little bit larger than that. But that was, they're fishing sort of beyond my range, about sort of 60, 70, maybe 80 yards, but still a little bit closer in compared to this morning. So, yeah, 15 minutes is up now, so I'm going to wind in. I haven't seen a bite yet, not that I recognise, because the tip's bouncing around, wobbling backwards and forwards in the wind, and obviously bouncing, dragging forward and back with the toe of the ocean, really, of the sea. I'm using a Ron Thompson kit, power wind Beachcaster 360, together with a Razor 80 reel, and I've just rebaited with worm and a little piece of squid on both hooks. So, second cast. Let's see if we can get something this time. Well, Alan Yates down there, he's just had another three codling on the same rig. Funny little sort of fish like that, but quite amazing to see. And I'm sort of struggling with this a bit. Having fished for coarse fish for 20 odd years, I'm thinking in my head, thinking, you know, there's got to be some sort of ledge or something, you know, because the sea, although it's flat, the groins are going down at, I don't know, 20 degrees or something like that. So there must be, at some point, where the shingle here stops going down and levels off, and I'm tempted to bring my rigs in. I mean, I don't know whether I'm right or not, because like I say, this is the first time, but I'm tempted to bring them in as close as I possibly can, really, to try and find where the drop-off stops and the level shingle begins, because, you know, instinct from coarse fishing tells me to find a ledge. I've dropped in short. I'm going to give that a try, come to about 35, 40 yards. Evidently, according to lads here who fish here quite regularly, goes from shingle straight down to flat mud. So maybe I found the place, I don't know. But big steep learning curve this for me. It's 25 past 12. We've been here since 8 o'clock. The tide's been going out all the time. And what's happened this last 15, 20 minutes is the lads have caught two quite substantial edible crabs, about that sort of size. You know, quite decent crabs. Which means that the cod and the whiting have gone off the feed. The crabs have come out to take advantage of this because they feel safe because the cod and whiting have gone off the feed. So the crabs have come out because they're safe. So we're going to endure that period where we're catching the crabs. I haven't caught anything yet. And then hopefully the tide will change slightly and induce the fish into feeding again. So I'm picking up all these tips all the time. I might well be wrong, I probably am. But there's a lot to take in one day, and I'm only 4 hours into this. So, I'll keep watching that tip and wait for it to wang over. Alan's been over, Alan Yates, he's just had some more coddling, a couple. Had a look at my rig, which was a box standard shop bought two-up flapper with a size 1-0 hook on, either boom, like. And wasn't quite happy with that, so we stripped it down, put on a clips rig, two hook clip rig, and same bait, blacks on the hook, but size 1 hooks, so a lot smaller, a lot finer, and a heck of a difference on the cast, heck of a difference, really, really wanged it out. So we're chasing the fish now, the tide's changed, sort of just basically trying to still find the fish, so yeah, double the distance now, probably about 80 yards I should think. Maybe 90, don't know, not quite sure, but a long way out anyway for me. Well, a little rattle then, and another little rattle. I think I've got a fish on. Feels a little bit heavier than before, but not much. Oh yeah. Yeah, it does feel heavier than before. Be good, possibly. See the shock leader now. Will it be a carrier bag? Hey, up, oh, there we go. What's this? Got something. There we go. Oh, brilliant. There you go. Fantastic. Fantastic. Oh, that's great. Proper bite as well. Now then, how do I get the bloody hook out of this thing? Right. Wow. There we go. First sea fish. Whiting. Fantastic.